Islam.
They wanna know about Islam, we'll give them da'wah. They wanna know why Muslim does, we'll give them da'wah. When they wanna hate on our deen, we'll give them da'wah.
Because it was impossible for death to hold him, right? So that's one verse. God saved him from
utter failure.
Death.
Utter failure.
Wait. There's no utter failure.
No, he's a burning in hell for eternity of your God.
Because God, look, death couldn't hold him. But tell me, Allah saved Jesus. Where's Muhammad?
But do not.
Run away.
The perfect from the subject.
The perfect man according to your religion.
To save you.
Hey.
To save him, how long does the Lord have to die and be born to have fire for? Eternity.
Muhammad, the
best
according to your religion.
Excuse me.
Well, you're not even saving yourself. Allah can even save you.
Listen.
No. I'm going to stop preaching now. Because you're preaching.
Listen.
Clearly.
Let me ask you.
You can be saved.
Let me ask you.
Allah saved Jesus.
If you're a man of integrity.
No.
You won't answer the question.
No.
Did Christ burn in hell for eternity?
You answer my question.
Did Christ burn in hellfire for eternity?
I'll let you read.
Okay, don't read.
You just asked me. You just said
I can read for you.
Read it.
Okay, let me read. But God raised him from the dead, freeing him from the agony of death, because it was impossible for death to keep its hold.
Impossible.
Right. So that means.
So then, according to
Let me finish. I want to tell you what I understand.
Much. I can't do with this.
I want to tell you much. I want to tell you what I've understood from there.
No, I don't want you to talk.
In this verse, it is impossible.
So stupid, man. I can't do it. I can't do it like this.
What's wrong with you? You say a verse, you got to explain the verse.
I got to explain the verse. Why is he explaining?
Yeah, he's explaining.
I bring up the verse.
What do you understand?
Who is it?
What did I understand from this verse?
Yes. Okay,
no, it doesn't make sense.
You guys are just bringing it up.
Excuse me. What did I understand from this verse?
You explain it. You explain.
Yeah, you explain.
Let me get. Yeah.
I'll
elaborate. Yeah, I'll get you the verse.
So the question is, did Christ burn in hellfire for eternity to save you from stealing the lollipop?
Silly question, man.
How come everyone else is in one mode? They all understand, and somehow you're the one out.
Because they're all deluded and told lies.
They're all deluded.
Yeah, you are.
You're the wise
because
one,
you don't believe, because you don't understand. You don't understand. Well, you're following people like this. That teaches you wrong stuff. That teaches you stuff that you can't think for yourself. That's why you ask the answers. You guys ask the same questions. You don't understand. But anyway, I'll read it.
Let me just... So we answer the question.
Propaganda.
Okay, let's see. Where Christ has burned in hellfire for eternity. You know what eternity means? Never ending. He should be still being burnt.
You're the one. You just made your own little gospel up about Christ burning in hellfire. The Bible doesn't say that.
Exactly.
You don't let my friend. Let me tell you what I'm demanding.
No, no, I've been listening. I know what I'm saying.
What's my argument?
You're the one. Well, you're talking about salvation, that who can die for our sins and everything.
No.
But that's what I'm...
No, you misunderstood. Let me help you with this one. Because you've got to understand. No, let me help you. Let me help you because you asked me.
Like the questions.
According to Christian belief,
yes.
If someone commits a sin...
The lollipop sin you were talking about.
Yeah. I just showed you how a mundane example of a sin requires...
No, exactly.
Eternal...
A mocking lollipop. Go on.
It's not mocking.
That's what I came in. Lollipop sin. Sorry.
Yeah.
Let me understand.
Well, go ahead, man.
He deserves punishment in hellfire for eternity. That is the punishment for any sin.
Wait. Just on that line. It's not correct, but just so that we understand each other.
What is the punishment for sin, according to the Bible?
The Bible is a death. Death.
Is what is death?
Well, death is being apart from God, being in hell, hellfire, whatever you want to call it.
How long for? In hell?
Sure.
In eternity.
Good.
Yeah.
So eternal damnation in hellfire.
Not accepting Christ.
Okay.
Not accepting. Mm-hmm. See what you're doing. Listen, you're correct. You're correct in what you're saying,
mm-hmm.
Okay? But you're going from one fence straight to the end, and you're missing out all the bits.
In order that, let's move on from the lollipop to not accepting Christ. Imagine now this friend doesn't accept Christ as the God or Son of God.
Uh-huh.
Right. According to your belief, mm-hmm. Christian belief,
that's when the Simpsons start.
Eternal damnation in hellfire.
Exactly.
Good. So if someone is going to save him,
mm-hmm.
they have to equally take that punishment on them.
Well, that's already been done.
Yeah, no, wait, just go. It's not on
us. You spoke.
Let me speak.
The reason he will go to hell, okay, is because he hasn't accepted Christ. And in accepting Christ, you accept what he has done for you. Meaning, dying for your sins. To redeem mankind back onto himself.
Yeah. But okay? What you've forgotten is this.
Sorry?
What you've forgotten is the reason why God came down and sacrificed his own life to save people is what you're missing. God needs to be, in your belief, God needs to be punished by himself, on himself. He needs to punish himself to save the people. The punishment that he needs to inflict on himself is eternal damnation in hellfire.
No, he doesn't have to, because he is God, which he just read to you.
Wait, he just read you something. So you don't believe in a just God?
You're not silly, man. Take an example. You're not silly, man. Okay? You're not silly, man. Be fair and just. You understand exactly what we're talking about, but in order for your audience here, you bring it over as a joke. The lollipop man, the this and that. You miss out stuff and you make your own.
This is where you're not being very fair.
I'm not being fair.
Let me tell you why. One moment. Look, justice demands justice. Now, here's the cause of justice. Justice demands that if someone commits a crime and deserves a punishment,
justice from whose point of view? Exactly.
God.
Are we talking?
God.
Oh, we see. But that's why we're here.
Oh, you're talking about justice,
and you're here saying another.
Justice from your God.
All right.
Is that fair? Good.
Yeah.
Right. Justice shouldn't be one only for God or one only for human. Well, justice should be a universal concept. That's what Islam believes. Anyway.
Come on, come on. Can I finish my example?
Okay. All right.
So,
according to the principles of justice, if someone commits a crime, deserves a punishment.
According to the principle of justice, according to Islam.
According to Christianity now.
According to Christianity now. Okay.
Correct me if I'm wrong.
You're telling me what?
Correct me if I'm wrong. So, if a crime deserves a punishment and someone's going to volunteer to take on that punishment, if his punishment was 1 year in prison and this gentleman volunteers to take 1 month in prison, has he taken the punishment that he deserves?
I would say yes.
I would say no, because his punishment that he deserved was 1 year. Justice demands that it's injustice.
Injustice or God's justice?
God's justice demands if his punishment was 1 year in prison, this gentleman should offer like for like. Like for like. God's justice in the Torah was tooth for tooth, life for life, eye for eye.
Can I finish? You've had enough.
Let me finish. You will have your chance. So are you saying if his punishment was 1 year in prison and this gentleman offers 1 month in prison, it's okay, it's fine?
What I'm saying is that just? What I'm saying is, the most just thing, which you don't seem to understand, right, is Jesus Christ died for all of our sins. And the reason he did, because there was no man, none of us, perfect enough to do this. So he gave his blood. And he is God. As we believe, the Trinity, which I heard you talking about, but I have to do it to back up what I'm saying, okay?
You're addressing what I'm discussing.
I am, because you're talking about this man. And I'm saying, listen, you can understand.
Are you a man of justice?
No, I'm not.
I'm being truthful.
Are you a good man?
That was not the question I asked you.
I'm asking you, are you a good man?
Ask me the question, am I a man of justice?
Are you a man of justice?
Yes.
Your justice.
Now, who's justice?
What's just for you may not be just for someone else.
Justice is universal.
So you're a man of arrogance and
justice is universal. So now, as you realize, I see you lost in your heart.
Listen.
What I realize is this. Some people like yourself, unfortunately, do not see what justice is. If he deserves 1 year in prison as a punishment, and he only applies 1 month, you're saying that's justice, it's fine.
I actually said nothing about that.
What Mr. is saying,
is it okay?
You're using a human fleshly example.
It's the same
I
example
that only okay. Go to the book.
In this fleshly example, what is just? To have life for a life, to have 1 month instead of 1 year.
This man is going to say another thing.
I'm asking you. Let me ask you this question.
You're asking me.
Yeah. I'm asking you. If he pays 1 month in prison, it's a punishment. Is that just? Is that 1 year?
Instead of 1 year. I would say no.
Yeah?
Thank you.
The punishment of
sin. This is my point. So,
you know what? I'm not blood.
Let me develop that.
I'm not eternal.
Let me continue what your heart agrees with you. That it is not just to only get away with 1 month in prison. So what you're saying is, if God or Christ volunteers to pay the penalty, that penalty has to be like for life.
I'm not punishing your sin.
Christians, unfortunately, including this gentleman and yourself maybe, have not pondered on this, but your Christian scholars, your Christian scholars have pondered and seen the problem with this substitutionary atonement, because the substitutionary atonement did not take place according to your theology. It just didn't happen, because if like for like was the case, then Christ or God himself should be punished in hellfire, in eternal damnation for eternity, which didn't happen. Because it didn't happen, there was no substitution. There was no salvation.
Listen, all you're doing is standing to claim, and you're not making any point. We're just saying this, we're just saying that. I'll just explain this.
It makes sense.
I understand, but I'm not saying
what I'm saying in Christianity, God has to punish himself to save human beings that he created.
God has laid down. No, it's not common sense.
If a human being doesn't acknowledge God,
it doesn't make no sense.
Doesn't acknowledge Christ, according to the Christian belief, he's gonna go to hell forever. Eternal damnation.
That's why you don't.
Now to save that individual, God has to offer himself to take that punishment. Now, if you want to take the punishment yourself, your punishment is what? Eternal.
Logical will take you to
suffering in hellfire. If he's going to volunteer, is it going to take 1 minute of it? No! He has to take life for life. So if God is going to volunteer, he must take how much punishment? Eternal punishment. Unfortunately, in Christianity, the theology that they have set up.
God does not die on no cross. What do you not think God
is? Exactly!
God is like us.
Exactly!
God doesn't die on
a cross.
Exactly! So you think God can die on a cross?
God deceived us, yeah?
God can die.
I'm saying you're an intelligent man and you understand where we're coming from. It's just that you have to argue your side of things. So very good. You've got a whole, you've got a good crowd here.
It's all right.
Top man, bloody
pop. It's all about crowd, my friend.
Just
an example.
I'm
I understand, you know, but look, if I'm standing there talking about Islam in a certain way, you know what I mean? I know you'll be on my point, alright? That's what I'm saying. No. All I'm saying
is, for us, brother, do you believe that God has to down across the
world? I'm hard talking, you know what I mean?
According to Christ, in fact, according to Christ, who is the only true God?
The Father. And he speaks about the Father all the time.
You know the real
speaks about the Father.
Who is the only true God?
You understand, brother?
The Father.
And who's the Son? The not true God?
You see, look, when he came to the world, and it tells us that in Ephesians, it tells us that when he came to the world, he emptied himself. He emptied himself and became a servant unto man, even unto the cross.
Come on, brother.
He didn't think it was good. He emptied himself of divinity.
Just hold on to this thought. God emptying himself of his divinity.
The scripture tells us that.
So listen,
who am I to question the world? Okay? I go in the world.
So basically, if a scripture says God became a turtle, or a fish, or a monkey, or an elephant,
Yep.
You're not going to question it. So the millions of Hindus, when Christ says, "You are the only true God," can he be the God as well?
Yes.
You speak English?
I speak English.
If he's the only true man on planet Earth,
why did he cut me off?
Talking about language, if he's the only true man on planet Earth, can you be a man as well on planet Earth?
Can you be a man as well? I don't understand.
If he was the only true man on planet Earth, can he be a man as well on planet Earth?
If he's the only true man,
Holy Bible,
yeah, I suppose so.
Jesus
Christ. So basically, we have a difficulty in the language. Either my English language is deficient or yours is deficient. Unless we clarify the linguistic problems, we should not continue talking anymore. Because if we say he is the only true man or true professor,